Okay, everybody, let's use the essay template to create our essay. And I want to work on my essay and store my essay online so that I can work on it from wherever I am. So I'm going to log into OneDrive. I've already downloaded the template from Moodle onto my computer. Now I just need to upload it right here, files. Go find it. It's in my downloads folder. Double click the template and it should, there it is, essay template right there. And I'll open that up. All right, I'm using Google Chrome. The first thing I'm gonna do is show you that I can rename this. So I'm probably gonna make it easier to find for myself. So I'm just gonna, you know, my essay was about passive solar, so I'm gonna rename it to that. So right now I'm in editing mode, which means I can click in here and make changes to this. I'm just gonna pick a new title, change the title. Okay, and so you can click in here and fill these in just like I have on my essay. But it's in edit mode. If I want to see what it looks like as a finished product, I can go view and then reading view. And now it's almost like it's ready to print, and you can see the page numbers are already there for you. The changes you've made are showing up, and this is already centered. And so your essay already has some work done for it by using this template. There's the conclusion and your references page. Click back here to edit it some more. Edit. Now I've given you some advice here, you know, how to create section one, and you can read that on your own time, and how to create the body, the section two and three and four, and however many sections you have in the middle. And these headings are optional, as it says, some advice about the conclusion, and then again, some advice about references and using this document to help create references. But what I want to encourage you to do is go back to your plan. So here's my section and paragraph plan. I already built it. I'm going to start by describing the problem and then my thesis statement. So that's what I'm gonna do right here. Okay, I'm gonna change this to match the title of my essay. I'm gonna highlight this right here. Okay, so I'm gonna have my problem sentence here and then my thesis sentence. And if we look at my actual essay, that's exactly what I did. I talked about the problem in here, how Canadian homes could be built better, and right there is my thesis sentence. I changed it a little bit. This thesis sentence changed a little bit from what I had here in the plan, but it's pretty close. And so my first section, my first paragraph is done. I'm ready to move on to section two. Back to my plan. Section two, I was gonna talk about how passive solar works. So that's what I do right here. Section number two, I have an optional heading. In my essay, I used it. So I changed this to something like how passive solar works. And then I started, and I think I ended up writing just one paragraph. How passive solar works, it was just one paragraph long explaining that. I did insert an image, you don't have to, but then I was on to section three. Section three ended up having three paragraphs or more, but I'm following my plan, materials used. Section four, I actually ended up combining section four and section five. It was about food and energy, and I combined the food and energy and costs and ended up creating food and energy cost savings and put those two sections into one. Then I had the conclusion right there, and I'm just using write the ideas that I had in my essay plan and turning it right into my actual essay right there. Here's the key. Your paragraph shouldn't be too long and they should have one tight theme. This paragraph is all about how passive solar works. But look down here. It's so obvious. The first paragraph is all about insulation. The second paragraph is all about the windows. The whole thing is about windows. Third paragraph here, talking all about thermal mass in this paragraph. And then in the last one, it's all about humidity. So the themes jump out when I read a paragraph. It should have a tight, obvious theme that jumps out at me. And I'm not repeating a bunch of themes. If this paragraph has a window theme, I'm not really talking about windows down here. And if this is about thermal mass, I'm not talking about thermal mass down here. I keep the paragraph focused on that theme, and my essay plan is really helping me do that. Now I want to talk about sentence length, and it's more important than you think. Here's an article from National Geographic about a rare bear in Mongolia. It's actually 8 pages long, and don't tell anybody, but I counted every single word in every sentence and put it into a little chart. And so some sentences I counted, there was like 2 words in a sentence, and that happened a couple times, or 3 words happened a couple times, 9-word sentences happened 4 times, and so on and so forth. The longest sentence was 40 words long, and that happened once. And it really starts to paint an interesting picture when you put it into a graph. We see at the start, you know, sentences that are really short, 2, 3, 4, 5 words, it's really rare. And sentences that are really long, 38, 39, 40 words, that's rare. But in the middle, we see sentences that are about 14 and 15. In fact, 15 was the average length of all of these sentences in 8 pages. Now, Ann Wiley, she's a writing guru. She says that if you have a sentence that's 8 words long, you have 100% comprehension. The reader understands what you're saying 100%. If we get up to our average of 14 or 15, we're already down to 90%. What that means is the longer our sentences are, the amount of comprehension decreases drastically. So we want to keep our sentences short so that comprehension stays high. We also want to keep our sentences short so that our grammar mistakes are also really, really low. Okay, let me show you something. If I highlight this line of text right here, it's not even a sentence, it's just a line of text at size 12 font, and I go to review and word count, it tells me that that's 14 words right there, what I highlighted. That's our average. So a line is our average. So now if I go and highlight my actual sentence, I don't have to count. I know that's under my average. I know my reader's not gonna have a hard time understanding that short sentence, and I know I probably don't have grammar mistakes there. How about this sentence? It's right about at the average, right about 14 or 15. That's great. No mistakes, probably easy to understand. And I can do that without counting. I just highlight. It doesn't take long. Highlight the sentence, see if it's short or not. Here's a sentence. Oh, it's a little longer. Oh, that's because of my interruption in the middle. That's why. How about this sentence? Wow, it's over 2 lines long. Warning bells, right? Do I have grammar mistakes in there? It's really long. Can I shorten it up? Is it hard to understand? Check your sentence length. The shorter, the sweeter sentences are always better. They're easier to understand and your grammar mistakes are gonna be low. Okay, it doesn't take long. It's a really good strategy. All right, I also mentioned grammar and punctuation. The goal is to have no grammar errors. So I actually colored my essay. No, you don't have to color your essay, but you should be able to in your mind. Right, and it shows me that I know what my punctuation's doing. If I have a comma right here and I turn this blue, I know I have an intro. All right, and so I'm explaining my punctuation. Here I have some dashes with an interruption, so I know what my dashes are doing. Another intro. Here's an add-on with a comma. Here's some commas that make up a list that's in the main sentence, right? So I can explain all of my grammar and punctuation. You need to be able to do that as well. If you can't explain your grammar, then it's probably wrong. Rewrite the sentence so that you can explain it. Here's some hyphens, right? We talked about that in our punctuation guide. So go back to your punctuation guide. Go back to those sentence parts tests and make sure that you can explain your grammar so that you know what's right. Now, sometimes we have a great topic and we even have a plan, but we don't know what to say. So I'm gonna give you 5 ideas, all right? One idea is to predict. Predicting is just thinking about the future and talking about it. Take your topic and think about what it's gonna mean or what it's gonna look like 5 years down the road, 10 years down the road, and write about that. You can't really get predictions wrong, and they're always kind of fun to read, so it's a really good thing to add even to an essay. Another thing you can do is ask questions. You can write questions right into your essay, and they're kind of fun. They draw the reader in. It's like you're talking to them. What do you think? Sometimes you ask the question and answer it. Sometimes you ask the question and there is no answer, especially when they're deep and thoughtful questions like, how can we make this better? Or why is this happening? Then it really makes the reading sometimes fun. Another thing you can do, and it has a few different titles, is connect, or some people call it making parallels or identifying with the topic. So let's say we're talking about space travel, but we've never traveled through space, but we have taken road trips. Well, now I can make comparisons and parallels and connections between space travel and a road trip, and I can add that to my essay. So look for places where you can make those connections, and that'll give you some ideas to write about. You can always talk about your feelings. Don't overdo it, but you can do it. Talk about, you know, why this excites you or worries you or scares you. But as long as you back it up with evidence, it's a fine thing to do. So why does it worry you? Why does it make you sad? Give those reasons, and then it makes the writing interesting to read. And you can put your feelings even in an essay as long as you don't overdo it. The last one is infer. Infer is thinking deeper. They call it reading between the lines. So you might be researching and learning about your topic online and it's explaining it in one way, but to infer means to think even deeper, maybe come up with a new meaning or even a new understanding of that topic. It's a tough one to do, but it shows a really mature mind. So try inferring if you get stuck. Now, if that didn't help you and you need even more ideas, you're going to have to reach out to me, but I'm happy to help you come up with some good ideas for your topic. Please don't just add fluffy words and repeat yourselves a whole bunch of times just to get enough writing to satisfy the essay or specifications. Don't do that. I'll help you come up with other things to say. And of course, at any time, if you're stuck with anything that has to do with your essay, let's do a Zoom call. You can share your screen with me. I can take a look at your essay and we can work on it to make sure that you're handing in your best writing possible. All right? Thanks for listening. We'll talk to you soon.